File handling. How do I read and write from files? So for file handling purpose, first we need to declare a file pointer. I've declared a file pointer, so it is file, all caps. Okay, and I've named it FP. So now, next thing is open a file, right? So you need to include stdio.h for file handling purposes. And so once we have declared a file pointer FP, you need to check, you need to open the file, a file. So opening a file is using the command fopen, and the first parameter you need to pass is you need to pass a string, which is basically the file name. Okay, so something like this would do. Myfile.txt. So in that case, it will look at the current directory to open this myfile.txt. Otherwise, you will have to give the entire path here. So that's the first parameter. The second parameter is, for what purpose are you opening the file? Do you want to read, write, or append? Okay. So the there are three things you can have. So if you pass W, it means I want to write into the file. So if you open in this mode, if the file does not exist, it will create a new file. It create a new file. On the other hand, if the file already exists, it's going to rewrite the entire file. Okay, so it's about write. Now, if it's R, I want to open the file for reading. And if it's A, I want to append into the file. That is, if the file already exists, I want to add at the end of the file. On the other hand, if the file does not exist, it's going to create a new file. So that's fopen. So you create a file like this, you open a file like this, and a file pointer is returned to FP. Now, if FP is null, that is what, and you get a null pointer back, it means there's something wrong. So maybe a file such as this does not exist. So you need to check whether if FP is null or not. If FP is equal to null, do something. Okay, that means there's some error. Otherwise, you can move ahead. Right. So now we have seen how to open a file. So once you have opened a file, you have read, you can use it for reading purpose if you have opened it for reading, write if you have opened it for writing, etc. And once everything is done with the file, you need to close the file by saying fclose and pass the file pointer. Okay. So this is important that you close the files you open. Similar to, you have to free the memory, all memory you have allocated. So you close, you call fclose and close it. Now, next thing is, how do I read, write into a file? To read from a file, you use fscanf, file scanf. Just like you use scanf to read from a keyboard, fscanf is used to read from a file. So the first parameter you need to pass to fscanf is the file pointer fp. Once the file pointer is passed, the next parameter is what kind of data are you going to read. It's exactly like scanf. You want to read a string, you write %s and then you give the string name. If you want, so here AR is a character array, and let me have an integer x, and if I want to read an integer, I will write exactly like scanf, just that I add a file pointer in the beginning. Okay, I have to give the file pointer, which file am I accessing? That's basically the idea. Okay, so you can use fscanf only if you have opened the file for read purpose, right? Okay, so this is to read. Now, how do you write into file? Like, how do you write into the screen? You use printf. So similarly, you use fprintf. What is the first thing you need to pass? FP, the file pointer. Next, you need to pass what you want to print. Okay, you pass %s a string and you pass the the array. It's exactly like printf, except that again you have a file pointer. So you could have done it for an integer also. Here you don't have to pass the pointer, but you pass the value of the variable x. So you could have had a float here by writing f. Okay. So it's same as, so this is to write. So we can use fprintf for both if you have to append or write into, if you had opened the file for both append or write, you can use fprintf. Okay. So this is to read and this is to write, and f open was to open the file, and in the end you need to close the file. Okay, so these are the basic operations on how to handle files. Thank you.